And you guys are wondering, what is this dude doing in the Jump Force lobby screen? What? Why is he showing his face? Of course, I'm doing a review for the Ewin gaming chair right here. So this one's gonna need my face on it. First of all, let's start by saying this. Shout out to Ewin for two things. One, they sent this chair at just the right time when I needed a chair, which was weird. It was super weird because literally the week I decided to throw out my last chair was when they hit me up, and they just so happened to also have a chair that was made for big and tall people. This one's called the Flash XL. Second one is they asked me to do an honest review of the chair. They didn't say this specific thing. Here's a talking point. Pitch this, pitch that, pitch that or the other. I do have an affiliate code, which is Papa Berto. And of course, that's completely optional for you guys to use. It saves you money if you do buy a chair from Ewin. It's not something that is going to be thrown at your face. It's going to be something that if you need a code to save you some money, it's going to be there. Okay? So shout out to Ewin for being very dope. Not a lot of companies do that nowadays where they give their product to a creator and they're so confident that it's a good product that they're willing to tell you, hey, do an honest review. So a lot of companies want you to say specific things and specific things only. Now, granted, I've only had this chair for 2 weeks. So as far as the durability, I can't really comment much on it, but I will tell you guys so far my experience with the chair. So let's start. So right off the bat, my last chair had a lot of issues. One, it was that it was not made for tall people like myself. It was a chair for big and tall people, but it wasn't for the kind of tall that I am. So I'm 6'6", by the way. So what that means is I'm taller than the average, more than the average tall guy, right? So having a chair that keeps me at a high enough level from the floor is very tough to find, okay? So I not only have the issue of finding a chair that can support all this love and goodness right here, I gotta find a chair that keeps me at a high enough level from the ground so that when I get up, it doesn't feel like I'm literally just carrying my entire body weight from the floor to then get up. So I can give him credit there. This chair is very nice. I think that it's for up to people that are 6'7", which not a lot of people are 6'7", except for like NBA players at that point. So it's good enough for me. I feel like it would be good enough for most tall guys, right? Especially if you're gonna be buying a gaming chair specifically because you're big and tall, right? You're gonna be good with this for that specific reason. Now for the next thing, when I'm gonna talk about features, I'm gonna show you guys the features of the chair post edit, just simply because I don't have the actual room to show you guys as I'm like showing my face. My green screen's right behind me and then the bed's right behind the green screen. You guys get it. But anyways, the chair can go all the way back and you can take a nap on it if you'd like. And if it's a thing that you could use if you want to. It's not like it's the feature that you buy the chair for per se, right? It's just an extra feature that if you wanted to use it, you could. The armrest not being attached to the back of the chair is amazing, all right? Not because it's a detriment to me in any way, but because it speaks for how durable the chair will be in the near future. So my big issue with the past chairs I've had before is that the armrest will always come off. And the reason why the armrest will always come off is not because I'm too wide, right? It would be because whatever weight I would put on the back of the chair, like on the backrest of the chair, would also be applied to the connecting joints of the armrest. So it adds that extra layer of wear and tear to the chair that you don't need. And this chair doesn't have that, okay? So it's a very good thing to see in chairs nowadays. Speaking of armrest, by the way, you could do a lot with the armrest on the Ewin gaming chair. You can move it to the left, to the right. You can actually lift up the height of the chair. You can decide to extend the armrest if you need more room. It's actually very customizable in that scenario. And I know that that's big for a lot of people because you need to rest. Like a lot of people put their elbows there or their forearms there, and it's just comfortable for them. And I get it, because let me tell you guys right now, when I had my last chair and the armrest on the left side fell off, it felt weird having that not be there anymore because I was so used to it. So having these armrests be customizable the way they are, very, very useful. The other thing that I wanted to say that I was really surprised at was just how good the base looks in terms of quality. It looks very durable. Looks okay. I've only used the chair for 2 weeks, so again, I can't really talk about the durability that much, but I'm just telling you guys off by how it looks. Other bases that I've had in my hand just don't have that weight to them, you know, don't have that feel of like sturdiness. So this one feels heavy duty, and not only that, the cushion actually has a lot of bars for support, and all of your weight is equally kind of spread out on the cushion, which is what you want, right? It's the same principle as like a bed. When you go on a bed, you don't want all your weight to be at a central point. You want the bed to spread out your entire weight across the entire bed, because that's what's gonna give you the most comfortable position, right? That's what's gonna help you feel comfortable when you put all your weight into one spot. And I like that. The chair does that very nicely. I've sat here for about 7 to 8 hours sometimes, and I haven't had an issue when it comes to like standing up or feeling like my back is hurting or anything like that. Now, of course, if I sit on a chair for longer than that, it's gonna be an issue for me just because I'm a big dude. But other than that, it's been fine. For the last point, the chair was very easy to build. You didn't need any tools for it. Everything that you needed to build the chair came with the chair. And I built it within, I want to say, 30 to 40 minutes. It took me a little while just because I had to make room to actually build it in my room. And it was fine. It was easy to do. And so far, like, look, I've only used the chair for 2 weeks, so I can't speak on anything long term. But so far, the chair has done whatever it needed to do for me, okay? I feel like that's about as honest as I can be with the review. And I'm going to give you guys straight up, I do have an affiliate code. If you guys want to buy a chair this coming Christmas or Black Friday, whatever, you guys can save some money when you do get the chair, okay? So the link is going to be in the description for Ewin. Again, shout out to Ewin for sending me a chair. Mighty, mighty kind of them. Shout out to them for allowing me to do an honest review of it. Mighty, mighty kind of them as well. So thank you guys a lot for the support. Without you guys, without this community, I wouldn't be able to get these opportunities. I wouldn't be able to sit on a comfortable chair talking to you guys about it right now if it wasn't for you guys supporting the channel. So thank you. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your week. I'm gonna be out. Peace.